I am Dr. Ravindra B.S., Director, Gastroenterology Hepatology, Meenakshi Institute of Gastroenterology, Bannerghatta Road, and Fortis Hospitals, Bannerghatta Road. Pancreas is an important organ which is there in the upper abdomen, just like the liver. It is useful for our digestion, and it is also the organ where the insulin production happens. That's why any problem in the pancreas, you will have few of these signs. The first sign is patient, usually they come with a pain, and pain is above your navel part, and it can be mild, sometimes can be very severe, and this pain can go back to the back. One is an abdominal pain, second is they can come with a back pain. This is the second sign in the pancreas. And third sign is they may develop diabetes, because pancreas is the organ where the insulin production happens. If there is any damage to the pancreas, people develop sometimes diabetes. That's why they may come with diabetes. That is number two. Abdominal pain, backache, and diabetes. Number four, the pancreas is important for our digestion. Pancreas produces lot of pancreatic juices, which are very important for digestion, especially the fat. Then the fourth sign is important sign is they start developing the weight loss because of the non-malabsorption. That is number four. Number five, these patients can also present with a stool which is very greasy stool or oily stool. These are the signs that the patient may have pancreas problems. Basically, to summarize, if you have an abdominal pain, if you have a backache, recent onset of diabetes, you start losing weight, and then the fourth important thing is you start noticing oil drops in the stool, then you should think that there may be a problem in the pancreas. And of course, some of these pancreas patients, the another sixth sign is sometimes they may develop jaundice as well, because the bile tube, the liver tube, goes through the pancreas, and sometimes these patients can even develop jaundice. Whenever there is a pancreas problem, they can develop jaundice as well. And then, is pancreatitis life-threatening? Not in all, but in small percentage of the patients, say 100 patients of pancreatitis come, almost 60 to 70% of these patients will be mild, another 20% of the patients will be moderate, another 5 to 10% of these patients, they develop severe pancreatitis. Severe pancreatitis means more than 50 to 60% of our pancreas gets damaged, and then once the pancreas gets damaged, these patients, they go on to develop lung problem. That's why they will have respiratory problems. They are put on ventilator, and same time when the pancreas, of so much of pancreas gets damaged because of an acute pancreatitis, we call it as severe acute pancreatitis, then the kidneys get damaged, and then their kidneys start, the functioning becomes less, and then they go on to develop dialysis. That's why severe pancreatitis is life threatening, and then they may need ventilation, they may need dialysis, and these pancreas which is damaged can get infected, and they can get lot of infections in their abdomen. Severe pancreatitis, yes, it is life threatening in some patients.